In the previous videos on this series, we've used new animation technologies to reanimate The Simpsons, Rick and Morty, and create whatever this is. Now, let's try and fix Star Wars, The Rise of Skywalker. With The Rise of Skywalker on the horizon, we all know that the best way to end an epic and beloved story is to turn the strong female lead evil at the end for no reason. So let's take this shot from the trailer and see how we can turn Rey to the dark side with some simple animation techniques. I'll be using EBsynth, which is a software that will apply the style of a single frame to the whole scene. It's got some limitations, but on a shot like this with little movement, it should be useful. We need to export the shot as an image sequence, which I've done in After Effects. This first frame here is the most zoomed out, where we can see the most background. So let's choose this one as our keyframe and take it into Photoshop. I found some references for the Emperor, and then first I darkened her top and desaturated the skin with an adjustment layer using the selection of her skin as a mask. I added a curves adjustment layer to darken the lips and around the eyes, using a mask to only affect those areas. Then I painted the sagging face wrinkles and discoloration of the eyes with the brush tool, just using a round brush with the opacity set to pen pressure. This is our final frame. With EBsynth open, I added the new keyframe which we just made, then added the image sequence for our original footage, chose what number frame it was, and then hit synth. And this could take a while depending on how long your shot is and the resolution of each frame. Here is what EBsynth rendered. It's not bad. The change of the color to the skin and to the top are pretty much flawless, but these wrinkles are jiggling all over the place. Clearly wasn't enough information in the original footage to track to. If we look at the original footage, there's not much contrast around the cheek areas. It's mainly sort of one flat fleshy color that doesn't change much frame to frame. I did hope this would turn out better for our first shot, but working in motion design is all about problem solving. So there's a few things that we can do to fix this. It's the wrinkles that are the problem. They're moving too much and they shouldn't really be moving at all. So I'm gonna try to track the static wrinkles to the motion of this shot. So let's hide this EBsynth layer. I'm gonna create a new null. And I'm gonna rename that track 01 because we always label our layers. I'm gonna select our original clip, go to the tracker window over here. If you can't see your tracker window, go over to window and it should be under tracker. If you can't see it in your workspace already. And then we're gonna select track motion. This will bring up a single tracking point. And we want to select scale, so it tracks both the position and scale of Rey's head. Because her face is going to get bigger as the camera gets closer. So this gives us two tracking points. It's best to select areas of high contrast that don't change much in the scene. So we're going to select Rey's hair over here. And then with this tracking point, I'm going to select Rey's eyebrow over this side. Because those areas have some high contrast and stay pretty stationary compared to Rey's movement throughout the shot. We're gonna select our target and make sure that is our layer one, our tracking null. And we're gonna select the play button, which will analyze this video forward. That'll take a minute or so, and then let's click apply. Now the position and scale data from that track is now keyframed onto our null. And if we scrub through, we can see it's reasonably accurate. Now to this composition, I'm going to add the still that we made of Rey all Palpatined up. And I'm gonna parent that to our tracking null using the pig whip. And with that pen tool selected up here, let's draw a rough mask around Rey's face. Now, that track isn't bad, but you can clearly tell that it's just a still over her face. Let's turn on our EBsynth layer again so we can see that underneath. Now you can see it matches much better, but the head still kind of sticks out a bit. We need to get back that movement in the eyes, nose, and mouth that were all pretty good from that EBsynth layer. So that's on that still, we're going to draw another mask, which is going to go around her eyes, nose, and mouth. And we're going to bring up our mask properties with M on the keyboard, and we're going to set our mask 2 to subtract, which is going to reveal the eyes, nose, and mouth underneath. Now we can still see a pretty crisp edge here, so let's feather that mask by pressing F on our keyboard. Let's make that about 30. Now if we play that back, the wrinkles are static and the rest of the face has that subtle movement and blinking. Now it's still not totally convincing, but there's a few more things to help make the scene more believable. We're gonna add some flame ember particles. Now you could make these in Trapcode Particular or even CC Particle World, but on MitchMartinez.com, Mitch has provided a bunch of free 4K stock footage, including a whole lot of ember particles that are perfect for this. And once you use these, you're gonna notice them everywhere, even in ads and movies all over the place. So let's drag that footage into our composition, set the blending mode to screen, scale it down. Now that we've got some additional destruction happening, let's add a camera shake. To add some camera shake, I'm going to add another new null. Parent our footage and our tracking null to our new camera shake null. Open up its position And I'm going to alt click the position stopwatch to open up our expression window and add the expression wiggle 12,3. And what this expression does, it will increase the position 12 times per second up to 3 pixels. And if we play it back, we get this rapid little shifting of everything, which mirrors a camera shake. And let's scale this up to 101% as well, so we don't get any little black edges as our footage slips outside the composition window. And this quick camera shake gives the whole scene a bit more weight to something destructive happening. But more importantly, it hides and distracts from the imperfections in this track and the comping of this new face. Now, these techniques of the particles in the camera shake can be a bit overused and used as a crutch, but I was desperate. Let's add a tiny bit of color correction with an adjustment layer and a curves effects applied just to make that orange pop a bit more. And for this shot, we're done. Now, this certainly wouldn't hold up in a studio setting or under a lot of scrutiny from a VFX enthusiast, but for 2 hours messing around in Photoshop, After Effects, and some free software, it's not bad. I also made a version replacing Rey's face with Chewie, which works as horribly as you might expect, and one with Jar Jar Binks as well. This once again is not great, but also not terrible for how different the faces are, and we can all agree that this trilogy is missing some desperately needed Jar Jar. I'm thinking of doing a video with Baby Yoda next in this series, so how should I vandalize or augment him with animation? Let me know down in the comments. Please let me know down in the comments what other animated properties you'd like to see me vandalize with this and some other cutting edge software. I'll see you in the next video.